The following program is sponsored by The Greek, Ely's Radio Shack dealer at 570 Altman in downtown Ely, and brought to you as a public service by Georgetown Media in Ely, Nevada. Ely City Council Meeting, July 14th, 2022.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I don't think we have anybody here tonight for the invocation, so.
Mayor Robertson?
Present.
Councilman Langus?
Present.
Councilman Carson is absent tonight. Councilman Spear?
Here.
Councilman Alder?
Present.
Councilwoman Williams Harper?
Present.
City Clerk Lee?
Here.
City Attorney Calhoun?
Here.
Public Works Supervisor Craycraft?
Here.
City Fire Chief Stork?
Here.
City Engineer Alber?
Here.
City Building Official Peterson?
Here.
And that's all.
Okay. With that, we'll move on to item two, public comment. Please state your name for the record, and you'll have 3 minutes.
And City Treasurer Trask is here as well.
I hear her. Public comment.
Go for it, George.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Mr. Mayor, sometime on July 3rd, 2022, my property was broken into and I suffered damage to a doorway and one outside wall was tagged with graffiti. That's the old school. During that same time period, the old Silver State Motel was broken into and tagged with graffiti, also suffering tagging. In addition to that, the jailhouse was tagged, the Happy Garden. I'm concerned that the council is losing control of the downtown business district. We are suffering from vandals, and you people are allowing the business district to look like a ghetto. That needs to stop. You failed to replace burned-out street lights that have been reported. Today I was told the senior center was also broken into. Take $100,000 of the money you pay the county for police patrol protection and install security cameras to monitor and protect the businesses and streets in the downtown area. The council is yet to address the status of the metal bleachers in the project park. I want to know what you guys are going to do with that $500,000 asset. I do not intend to stand by and watch people destroy the downtown area. You got to get your act together. Mr. Mayor, on your mayor's report, you approved the 24 liquor license to sell a sucker that has a county liquor license. To qualify, they need to have a city liquor license first, before they can go to another location. You need to collect the city liquor license now. No political favors. Mr. Mayor, on agenda item 11B7, reconsider adopting proposed ordinance 746. I want to remind you that the previous building inspector through the court and shoddy workmanship on the roof installed in my building at 570 Altman. The roof still leaks today. When I put the city council on notice, your inspector said, George, hired a work contract. When I told the council the inspector should have stopped the work and that he's liable for approving and signing off on a poor roof inspection, he told me F-U-U-F-N-P, in a public meeting no less. Now, this is a new ordinance. You approved section 9-1-6, non-liability of the city. If the city forces me to pay for a permit, the so-called protection, against shoddy workmanship, then the city is obligated to pay me for proper protection and pay for the proper repairs, and I'm having your city inspector tell any citizen, F-U-U-F-N-P. You people may be used to that language, but I am not. Mr. Mayor, you have not provided for my public information request dated May 9, 2022, regarding the unwarranted complaint against my brother's property located at 842 East Dalton, and my request regarding if the complaining party also filed a complaint on 894 East Almond for not having proper ADA access and off-street parking as required by code. The city is selectively enforcing the law and discrimination needs to stop.
Thank you, Mr. Chancellor.
I need some answers, Mr. Mayor.
there any other public comment?
Just real quick. Janet Van Camp, County resident. I noticed as I've gone down Main Street, the flower planters have been removed, and I just think that's a crime because it really did a lot for the Main Street, made it look freshened it up, and they were really pretty. I think you should bring them back. And I hope you don't get rid of the little benches. Thank you.
Thank you.
May I make a comment?
Sure.
During the winter chapters of public comment, if he continues to reference one business, it's very slanderous what he does. Name of the business is Salt and Sucre. He calls them Salt and Sucker every single time. It's Salt and Sucre. I think he needs to stop. We know nobody offends him. His business isn't called by that kind of names. And he knows what the name is, and we need to have that discussion before.
They suckered you, buddy.
Salt and Sucre, George.
It's a great dish.
Any other public comment? Hearing none, we'll move on to item three, mayor discussion for possible action, approval of agenda, including removal of agenda items. I'll entertain a motion. Motion from Councilman Spear, do I have a second?
Second.
Second from Councilman Oliver. Is there any further discussion? All in favor? Any opposed? Carried, so ordered. Item four, city department reports. We'll start with fire chief.
Good evening. So we finally got Assistant Chief Charles Scott had been off for 15 months on injury. July 7th, he finally returned to full duty with no restrictions, put us back to full staff. However, on July 12th, Assistant Chief Bodine Cole, it was his last day. He took a position with White Pine County Sheriff's Office, putting us back down one position. We flew that job announcement on June 20th, and at this time, we have received only one applicant, which is in-house. We have received nothing from the outside. We're close to the job connect. We've sent the state EMS. All the places we can think that we normally apply around the state, we send it to. So it's out there. We'll do that. We'll apply the call at 29th. At that point, we're going to make a decision. We're ready to go with it. So with Cody leaving, it's left a lot of duties that I need to transition over to other people. I've been working with the plan. Met with the treasurer, met with my liaison, the attorney, working on some ideas and some plans right now. I'll have a more detailed report on that at the next meeting to go over that with you. Also today, Rescue 6, we had Rocky Mountain Ambulance out here. Rescue 6 is an ambulance that's owned by White Pine County that we leased for the dollar. It had some warranty issues. We had the drill guard, had some cracks in it. They're taking it back to Utah. They're going to replace that under warranty. The air conditioning quit on it again, so it's essentially useless for the ascendant weather the way it's been. We have no cooling for the patient in back or the driver, so they're taking it back to Utah. In the meantime, I did get another ambulance from White Pine County. Chief North brought over. We got put in service, stocked up today, so we are sending back to three ambulances. One's not super reliable, but we have something in place. Hoping to have it back to us within 7 to 10 days, depending, so that they have to take it over to Ford dealership to have it worked at, and you know, for them, it's, who knows what the time frame should be. If there's something they can fix in-house on air conditioning, we could have possibly have it back sooner. So, you know, that's it, unless anybody has any other questions or anything on the report.
I was pleased to hear about Assistant Chief Stark's performance at the
Always
great that we got those recommendations.
This department's always had a strong presence over the years at the state NSFA complex. We're the only department to ever win and retire the water fight trophy twice and reinstate it. And it's a trophy that's been going around the state since the 50s. And we're the only department to ever do that. The Councilman Allworth was on the team back in the day, but they did that all the time. So, yeah, it's good to see the department represented and doing well again. So.
Any other questions?
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Chief. Police Chief is here tonight, the Municipal Court Judge, Judge Coster.
He is not.
Yes, good evening, sir. I have nothing at this meeting, but we'll at the second meeting of the month.
Okay. Thank you, Judge. City Attorney. City Clerk.
So, Super Title informed me that the title search on the Georgetown Ranch should be finished next week. week. I've got a request in First American Title on whether they can do the title search for the Belford property. I received notification from the EPA that our earmark, our community project funding, will be available through a grant process, and they will let me know when I can apply for that. The BLM has requested additional information for our criminal grant, which I'm providing them. The city's first CDBG hearing will be on the 28th of this month, so if you have projects in mind, if you can get with BJ or let me know. I met with Nevada Water's new circuit rider for the city, Danny Lofton. He worked in a treatment plant in Texas, and so it's nice to have someone there with some true work experience. And to date, my office has received 29 complaints this year. 10 of those remain active, with one complaint from 2021. There are a total of 11 active complaints.
Any questions for the clerk? Thank you. City Treasurer. Okay. City Public Works Superintendent.
I got a few updates to the dozer. I talked to Wheeler Machinery today. It's completely torn apart. They're inspecting all the parts to decide what they can use and what they have to replace. You should know more next week. Number two, the truck that was purchased 2 years ago, or ordered 2 years ago, is sitting in Carson City. It should be delivered in the next week or two. That's all paid for and done. And then this Sunday, got 1 to 2, the NHP, the task force, and Monday from 10 to 12, we'll be practicing helicopter, just their exercises out there on the park. They'll be doing all security, and we'll be shutting the park up, and then that's just to make sure that that's possible.
Did they notify residents around the area that you could hear leaving the, I guess it's Sunday, so someone's going to be in the office, but the sheriff's office will be at the call.
I will make sure that. I don't know for sure.
Okay.
All right.
See, that one well was doing real well, Mike.
What's that?
The one well was doing an exception.
Well. I see that, eh? Thanks for
City Water Operator, you have their report, City Engineer? City Engineer.
I
We've been working with Mountain League Power. They're doing some power upgrades in East Stevens. We've been working with them with their power poles and such. And it looks like at the end of this project, if there's potential, there would be a net reduction of 4 poles in the city, which is a benefit to the marketplace because there's lots of extra poles. And we got an RNMC negotiation meeting next Monday, so we've been doing some work to prepare for that.
I'm at the airborne group. We got 3 15 million. There's two different classes on that. You can plan on sending them on them. I know Jennifer said that. Yours is going to be the 26th.
27th. And the others are 19th.
Is it? Okay.
It's 19th on the 26th, but I think the 2 days were.
Okay, yeah, no, we definitely can sit on that. We go to Jennifer and see if we can.
City building.
Happy to answer any questions, nothing to report.
Okay, thank you. For item number 5, I'd like to disclose that I am a part-time employee of the NRY Foundation, and I'm not a voting member of this body, and this is just a report, so I will not be abstaining. An NRY Foundation report.
Okay. Good afternoon. Big news down the track is we've actually fired up locomotive 801. That was built in 1942. It's a diesel locomotive. The crews have been working at it for the longest time, and she fired right up. So, and you can pull wheelies with her, we found out the hard way. So, she still has more work to do, but she'll be entering our leading engineer pool for next season. The other big news is, too, in June, we carried 2,927 passengers. It's a 14% increase over 2021. And 2021 was our largest June ever, and so we beat that. We had the largest June in 35 years. So, and we also had the largest May in 35 years. And July seems to be continuing that trend. Year to date, we've carried 6,083 passengers. And that's a 14% increase over 2021 too. The economic impact, those 2,927 passengers brought $327,824 into the community in the month of June. And for the year to date, we brought in $681,296. Our social media continues to climb. Last month, we reached 885,000 people, and our post engagements was 239,000, and we have 116,000 page likes. So, yeah, and things are just still staying busy. So, that's about all I got. Does anyone have any questions at all?
That was a good one. I have a question about. In respect of SNS and Mike Quinn, I do believe in February when we finalize the deal with SNS, so that they were to remove all of their equipment off by, I believe, the 22nd of July.
The 31st of July.
All right, 31st.
Yes.
Has anything been done?
The last time we checked, which was middle of June, there were still cars there. I'm going to be going up there next week to see what they have there.
Is there any provision or agreement that if they're not moved off, what's going to be the penalty?
You know, that's a question for the attorneys. I don't have an answer for that.
And I'd have to look at the agreement again.
We're not very far from the 31st of July. Mm-hmm. And I'm just wondering what's going on with COVID.
Yeah. It, like I said, we were up there in the middle of June and there were still cars there. So, yeah. But the cars they have, it's all from the same company. So it's not like they have scattered cars. So all they need to do is get a locomotive there and just pull them out onto the UP and they're done.
That's good.
Pardon?
That is not what you have.
No, we don't do that at all. That's up to SNS to do. But my point being is it's very simple rules for them to clean out all of their. Now, that all being said, that's the railroad cars that they got stored there. They have a locomotive, a tie camper, and miscellaneous other things scattered across the railroad. If that is not removed by July 31st, that becomes property of the city and the foundation. So they have some track equipment there. And like I said, one small locomotive.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Any other questions? Thank you.
All right, thank you.
Item 6, report to City Council. We'll start with Councilman Plankus.
Yes, the report I'd like to make is we went through a report in July just recently, and kind of, as far as I'm concerned, the brain and everything, so within the city of Haiti, there's no participation from the city in respect. I do believe that honoring our nation and honoring our community, further on when we have a purpose like celebration, something should be thought about putting into advertising, not advertised, but recognize the city within the frame of their company. And I wish we could all kind of, an encouragement of that with others, businesses and whatnot. We used to have parades that last a long time with boats, horsemen, stagecoaches, and everything. You see none of that anymore. It would be nice to retrieve our heritage.
Thank you. Councilman Seer.
How would that make it?
Councilman
Nothing, Mr. Mayor. Thank you.
Councilwoman Williams, sir.
Just a report of a bit of a different kind. Just to say, still going to be on the council, but it's the council is meaning just so much more because I'm learning so much more, and I just think it's important for people to know. If people see it that I don't understand something, they're saying, "Can we help you with that?" Or if I don't understand something, I'm able to go to people. So I'm just having more conversation with all the folks in the office, you know, our attorney, our heads of our departments, and my fellow councilmen. And I just think that that's really important because this is such an important job. And it's really a hard job if you don't know what's going on around you. And so I'm just feeling like I'm starting to crack open my jaw a little. So that's just kind of just a thank you to everyone who runs the city, because it's a huge, huge learning curve, but it's important, so just say thank you to everybody.
Thank you. Is that my report there? Don't think I have anything else to add. Item 7, the mayor will recess the regular city council meeting for a meeting of the Eden Liquor Licensing Board. Item 1, board members' discussion for possible action. Approval of Class 4 liquor license effective immediately to Mindy L.C. Jensen, DBA Eden Tavern LLC, located at 301 Alton Street, Eden, Nevada.
May I ask a question?
Please.
So this is for taproot, correct? So
yes.
They'll start serving liquor.
As I understand it, the remodeled back section, that's where that will be served. That's my understanding.
So it's a new section?
Yes, it's connected, but people will be entering from that, from the door on this side.
Okay.
Yes.
I also have a question.
Yeah.
So on that statement, Jennifer, does this liquor license go into effect, right, if we approve it tonight? Mm-hmm. And
yes,
when do they have their remodel done? I just wonder about the one stipulation says, with a minimum of 12 seats. They got 12 inside the place right now. So that's a key thing, a minimum of 12 seats. I don't know why that is
out
there.
Yeah, I will verify that.
But the 12 seats are where they're not serving the alcohol. Am I correct?
They have to be.
Because it's not enough. It's not in the front part where everybody goes, and you said they're building them on the backside.
Right, on the back, it depends. You know, Alton is the front, St. Alton's the front, so the back on Clark Street.
That's the place. It's the next one.
It's called the place, they're going to do seven feet in there.
Oh, okay. So it's almost like a separate entity, so to speak.
The separate building is got a door that goes between the two businesses.
Gotcha, okay.
But it's a separate business that sits to the east of the tap, the very next portion of that building.
Okay, good.
To the east?
Yeah.
So it's the old Mrs. Fancy.
So the question is, that's where the 12 seats have to be at for the liquor license. So if you want a beer or cocktail, you've got to go next door.
My knowledge, that has to be issued a business license yet. From what I know, me and Greg haven't finished all that, so I don't know if that plays in or not.
What was that?
Right, so that part is getting approved, but they can't. The county starts serving liquor tomorrow until they finish all the stuff that me and Greg have to do to get their business license.
So I guess the question would be, can the council make this approval contingent upon their business license inspection?
Yeah.
Dale made the motion to approve this at this time and not to issue it until I got all the fire department doing the inspection.
I have a motion from Councilman Howard and a second from Councilman Williams. Is there any further discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Carried and so ordered. We'll be convening the city council meeting. Item 8, the mayor will be in recess. Not quite 5:30. So the utility board real quick, item 10. Items for discussion, possible action of the Eva City Council as recommended by the Municipal Utility Board. Item non-board members, city quickly, discussion for possible action. Approval to remove the past due utility fee penalties up to the amount of $7,752.41. From 48 Keystone Street, number 1, Ruth, Nevada, at the request of property owners, Novella Sorensen and Leon Russell.
Utility board recommends approval.
What's the pleasure of the board on this item?
So moved.
Motion from Councilman Howard, go ahead, second.
I'll second.
Second. From Councilman Williams, our first hearing for this discussion.
I hope this isn't such a naive question, but they've got penalties. Do we have, is it okay for us to ask why or how long or what, or do we just,
well,
is this the place to do that?
Yes,
or I can do the office?
Yeah, of course it's okay. The prior owner is deceased, and so the new owners didn't accrue all these penalties.
Okay.
So they came in and asked if there was something that could be done, and we told them they could request to have the penalties waived after they paid the principal owed, which they did. So, okay, thank you.
Any further discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
Nay.
3-4-1 against. Item passes with majority. Item 2, board members, city clerk, lead discussion for possible action, approval to remove past due utility fee penalties up to the amount of $4,302.82. From 8th Avenue A, McGill, Nevada, at the request of property owner Heather Harrison.
So I'll ask again, what's this one about?
Similar situation.
The recommendation of the people.
Yes, they approved it.
What's the pleasure of the board on this side?
I'll make the motion to approve the action.
Motion from Councilman Oliver, do I have a second?
I'll second.
Second from Councilman Williams, our first. Any further discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
Approving.
3-4-1 against. Item passes. Now it is barely 5:30. Oh, put them back real quick to 8. The mayor will recess the regular city council meeting for a public hearing at 5:30 p.m. on the following topics. Item 1, Councilman Howard, public hearing discussion only. Approval to remove stop signs at the following locations: Murray Street and First Avenue, Murray Street and Third Avenue, comments from the public on this item as well as the board.
Stop me.